Hi everyone, it's Heather at Gypsy Crafter Journals. I am just quickly showing you these books. I've been playing this afternoon and I did a couple of journal covers. I have filmed the process and I'm going to put it on after this, and I'll speed it up, and if I can find some music that's not so offensive, I'll put that on. Hopefully if you want to see how I do it, you'll be able to sit through that. I didn't talk for it because I was just sort of in the zone and enjoying myself, but I'll just go through very quickly what I used for the journal covers. These ones, they're just books that I happen to have in my stash. I sell these ones in the shop. They're really inexpensive. They're just basic craft cover notebook jotter type things, and this one was a 2018 class journal, which obviously I wasn't going to use. It was totally empty, so what I wanted to do was just cover the front cover with something so that it would become a useful art journal. There aren't a huge number of pages in there, but I thought rather than chuck it or dismantle it, it would be nice just to cover that. I've got a lot of that type of book, so I'll be probably doing a few of these in the future. So I've used on these some doll faces that will be going in the shop as printables. These are available as an A4 downloadable and printable sheet, so you get the blue-eyed girl and the green-eyed girl, which is the same doll, and this one, which has got violet eyes and green eyes, so you've got a little bit of variety, and they're just on the one sheet so that you can cut them out and use them for your projects. I've got larger versions and a different sort of project to do with a very similar one that I've showed you a journal cover using this doll before, but I was just playing around to see how I could use them, and I just wanted to do a little bit of doodling and a little bit of getting messy. You can see I've got a little bit inky while I've been working. So this one, I started off by gessoing the cover, and then I use these. I don't know whether they're still available, but I got mine from eBay, I think, years ago, called Posh Rainbow Ink. It's non-toxic, acid-free, and they're earth tone colours. So, oh, it's Ranger. Oh, that's interesting. I didn't even realise that there were Ranger products. Anyway, they do stain the skin, so be aware. But I got them in earth tone colours, so I use those as a sort of basis for the colour behind the girl's face. Then I used a black pen to doodle on and a gold pen just to add a little bit of detail, and obviously stuck my girl's face on the front. So I really enjoyed doing that, and that gives a little bit of shimmer. They're brilliant, those gold pens. Let me just see if I can find the ones that I used. So I was using these Pilot gold pens for the details on this particular one. Then on this tiny book here, I used this doll image with the violet eyes, and I used a background of gelatos by Faber-Castell. You probably all have these. It's the first time I've ever used these, but I had the pack absolutely ages ago, and I literally opened it for this project, and I never used them before. I've sort of been hanging my nose over them for ages, and I bought these actually a long time ago because it was from TK Maxx, and I haven't been to TK Maxx for well over a year. So I thought I'd open those and have a play, and actually they were really good on the cover. They provided quite good coverage, so I did them straight onto the craft card, so you can see that it's actually provided quite a nice coverage. And then I just obviously stuck my girl in place, and I added a little bit of fabric. So these are offcuts that I have from applique that I've done in the past, that I've actually got the No So Heat and Bond Ultra on the back of them, which makes it almost like fabric paper, so they're really easy to use. And I've got loads of this stuff as a little offcut, so it's nice to be able to use a few offcuts of that. But you could easily just use scrapbooking card or paper or whatever, or doodle on it. And then I just used a little bit of twine in different colours to sort of complement the colours that I was using, and then added a little bit of lace at the last minute just because I like the idea of having that texture on the front, just to cover half of her face. So I like that. I love the way they've turned out. So that's using these doll faces here. I've got a few projects coming up involving those, because I drew them quite some time ago, and I've just got around to making them into digital images. That's my husband just shouting me, so I'll round up now. So I'll put the video on after this, and you can see how I did it. Enjoy, and come back soon. Take care. Bye.